Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Saurabh Mani Tripathi and you are watching my YouTube channel Double E Lectures. The topic of this short lecture is direct current machines, losses and efficiency. A DC machine can be operated either as a generator or as a motor, and it is decided by the input to the machine, whether it is being a mechanical power input or an electrical power input. However, it is impossible to convert 100% power input into the output, since various losses occur in different components of the DC machine. Owing to the law of conservation of energy, the input power must always be equal to the output power plus the losses occurring in the DC machine. Though different losses occur in different ways, all of them cause heating. The heat generated by these losses increase the temperature inside the DC machine, which affects not only the life of the insulation but also the performance of the DC machine. These losses include mainly core losses, copper losses and mechanical losses. So before we define the efficiency of the DC machine, let us first understand these losses one by one. Core losses in DC machines. The core losses are also known as iron losses or magnetic losses. These losses result from hysteresis and eddy currents due to alternate magnetization of the armature core material. Now the first question is, how hysteresis loss occur in the armature core of a DC machine? So let us find the answer to this question. In reality, when any particular segment of the armature core passes under successive north and south poles due to the rotation of the armature, the magnetic domains in that particular segment of the armature core material are subjected to magnetic field reversals. As we know, the domains in any magnetic material do have a tendency to align themselves in the direction of the magnetic field. For that reason, with the rotation of the armature in the magnetic field, the magnetic domains in the material of the armature core starts rotating to and fro. Consequently, some power is wasted on account of to and fro rotation of the magnetic domains in the material of the armature core. As a matter of fact, the hysteresis loss depends upon the maximum flux density in the magnetic material and the frequency of magnetic reversal. So this is the expression to calculate the hysteresis loss. In this expression, KH is the hysteresis constant whose value depends upon the nature of the armature core material. BM is the maximum flux density in Weber per square meter. F is the frequency of the magnetic reversal in cycles per second. And VC is the volume of the armature core material in cubic meter. Now let us see how eddy current loss occurs in the armature core of a DC machine. In reality, when the armature rotates in the magnetic field, an EMF is induced in the armature core also, in the same way as EMF is induced in the armature conductors. Therefore, the EMF induced in the armature core generates a circulating current in the material of the armature core. These circulating currents are termed as eddy currents. These eddy currents necessarily cause a power loss in the resistance of the armature core called eddy current loss. Now the question is, how big is the eddy current loss? The answer to this question can be given by means of an illustration as shown in this slide. In case we use a solid piece of iron to make armature core, the resistance offered to the eddy currents would be very small due to the large cross-sectional area of the armature core. Consequently, the magnitude of the eddy currents and hence the eddy current loss would be very large. Now the question is, how to reduce the eddy current loss? The solution is to reduce the magnitude of eddy current in the armature core by making the core resistance very high. The core resistance can be greatly increased by constructing the armature core using very thin iron sheets called laminations. The laminations in the armature core are insulated from each other with a coating of varnish, which offers a high resistance, causing a very low current flow from one lamination to the other. Moreover, because each lamination is very thin, the resistance offered to the current flow through the width of a lamination is also quite large. This way, the resistance of the armature core is greatly increased, resulting in reduced eddy current and hence reduction in the eddy current loss. Now, this is the expression to calculate the eddy current loss. In this expression, Ke is another constant called coefficient of eddy current, and its value depends upon the nature of the armature core material. Moreover, T represents the thickness of the core laminations. It is also worth noticeable that the eddy current loss depends upon the square of the lamination thickness. For this reason, the lamination thickness should be kept as small as possible. In reality, the mechanism of core losses is very complex. It is not possible to compute its value accurately. However, if the flux density of the magnetic field and the speed of the DC machine remains constant, the core losses will also remain constant. The copper losses in the DC machine. The copper losses occur due to the currents flowing through different windings of the DC machine. Hence, the copper losses can be segregated as shunt field winding copper loss, series field winding copper loss, armature winding copper loss, interpole winding copper loss, and compensating winding copper loss. The copper loss in any winding depends on the resistance of the winding and the square of the current flowing through that winding. Furthermore, it is worth noticeable that the series field, interpole, and compensating windings are connected in series with the armature of the DC machine, and thus they carry full armature current. For this reason, the copper losses in series field, interpole, and compensating windings are proportional to the square of the armature current. Mechanical losses in DC machines. The mechanical losses in the DC machine are due to the friction between the bearings and the armature shaft, the friction between the brushes and commutator segments, and the windage or air friction. To reduce the friction loss caused by armature rotation, the bearings are usually lubricated. Note that the mechanical losses depend on the speed of the DC machine. However, for a given speed, these losses can be considered constant. Stray losses in DC machines. There are some additional losses in the DC machine that cannot be easily accounted for. Such losses are termed as stray losses. The stray losses typically occur in the machine when they are loaded. In small machines, the stray losses are mostly ignored. However, for large machines, the stray losses are generally considered to be 1% of the output power in total. Efficiency of DC machine. The efficiency of a DC machine, typically denoted by eta, is defined as the ratio of the useful output power to the input power. So we may write eta is equal to output over input. Now, the output can be expressed as input minus losses. So we have eta is equal to input minus losses over input. Similarly, if we express input as output plus losses, then we have eta is equal to output over output plus losses. A detailed discussion on the efficiency of DC machine as well as power flow diagram would be made in my next video lecture. So keep watching and do like this video and subscribe to my channel. Please don't forget to share your learning experiences on this short video lecture. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.